Motors are among the most valuable devices in modern times, used in a wide range of electrical appliances, from small ones like kitchen gadgets to massive systems like trains. The term motor encompasses any power unit capable of generating motion. It is a device that converts electrical energy into mechanical energy. Here, the electricity flows into the motor, causing a shaft to rotate. This shaft is often connected to a gear mechanism that, in turn, drives the wheels or performs other mechanical tasks. It's designed to produce motion or rotation based on the principles of electromagnetism. Let's first establish the fundamentals of magnets. A magnet is an object with a unique ability to attract certain materials, such as iron, steel, and nickel, even when these materials are not in direct contact with it. Magnets have two ends, which are called the North Pole and the South Pole. These poles have different properties. If you bring the North Pole of one magnet near the North Pole of another magnet, they will push each other away. This is called repulsion. However, if you bring the North Pole of one magnet near the South Pole of another, they will attract each other. This is called attraction. The South Pole of a magnet behaves oppositely. It attracts the North Pole of another magnet and repels the South Pole. The area around a magnet where it can attract or repel objects is called its magnetic field. These are the magnetic flux, and the direction of this flux is north to south. We can also make a magnet by using electricity, a conductor, and a bolt. We need to wrap the insulated copper wire tightly around it and connect the wire to the battery. After that, the bolt picks up small metal objects and also attracts the opposite pole of a magnet. It is called an electromagnet, and it creates a magnetic field around it. This magnet is very special because you can control it by switching off the power supply. If you observe the magnet closely, you'll notice that its pole changes when the wire is switched. Now, if we place this bolt in this manner and connect the wire, the magnet turns on. Again, if you reverse the wire, the poles of the electromagnet will reverse. Here, the same pole repels and the opposite pole will attract each other. To make it stronger, let's place another permanent magnet on the other side. Just reverse the wire and it will spin. This is a very basic concept of an electric motor. Let's improve it with a curved magnet, which is stronger, and take a wire instead of the bolt. This is called armature. If we connect the wire like this, the electromagnet's south pole is at the top, and the north pole is underneath. We can keep it spinning by simply switching the wires. In reality, switching the wire can be a challenging task. That's why a commutator is used. It resembles a ring and contains two small gaps, enabling it to rotate smoothly along with the armature. Now, connect the brushes on both sides and connect the wires. The current flows from the brush to the commutator ring, through the armature, and then to the other side of the commutator, via the wire. As we have the electromagnet, the armature will spin. During its spin, the brushes switch the other sides of the commutator ring. After switching the commutator ring, the electromagnet changes its pole, and the armature's rotation continues. But, the brushes switching the commutator, it break the speed. For good speed and continuous rotation, need more armature. Now, when the brush makes contact with the commutator ring, it completes the electrical circuit with the electromagnet, causing the armature spinning. When the commutator switches, the current loop turns off, and a new loop turns on, resulting in the electromagnet spinning. In some cases, having more armature windings can lead to higher speeds and improved motor performance. The spinning force generated by the armature in a motor, it is called torque. The electromagnet's strength is enhanced by its armature. Wrapping more wire around it results in greater strength. Finally, all these parts are kept inside the motor case. There are two most common electric motors, AC, alternating current, and DC, direct current. This is a DC motor, often powered by batteries, and can be found in various applications in our daily lives. An AC motor operates on alternating current and is commonly used in a wide range of applications, such as trains, as we discussed before. In this video, we've delved into the fundamental principles of electric motors and their operational mechanisms. If you love this learning, say yes. Thank you. Let's grow up. Never stop learning.